Boys and girls, welcome back. I am here at the Cold Tour, Kopeck Tour, Sayreville, New Jersey at the Starland Ballroom. I am here with Benjamin. Benjamin.
My name is Benjamin Dmitruk. I am guitar tech, backline tech for the band Cold. I've been on the road with them for this tour for about the last week and a half, so we're getting things rolling right now. And basically my responsibility is I make sure that all the guitars, all the basses, all the backline is up and running and everything's operating on full capabilities. Generally we roll in, we do a load in about 11, 12 o'clock. I don't know if you can see behind us, we've got all these amp racks behind us. Those come in, get uncased, set up, get all the amplifiers hooked up, run through a sound check. We'll actually have the front of house engineer getting the sounds out there. Have the band come in, make sure they've got their monitor mixes right, and then after that, I pretty much come here. This is my guitar world. All of its glory. And I just basically maintain all the instruments. I'll make sure that they're playing the way that the players want them to play. We've got Zach Gilbert on guitar, lead guitar, Drew Molleur on rhythm guitar and lead guitar, and then Jeremy Marshall on bass guitar. So let
me reiterate. You absolutely. Are the tech for three. Two electric guitarists, one bass guitarist. You're it.
That's right.
So this is the guy.
Then actually right now I'm actually working on Jeff from Egypt Central. They're the band that's about to do soundcheck right now. I'm working on one of his guitars, getting that up and running for him. And, you know, I kind of do some freelance stuff on the side for anybody that needs some work on the side, too. So
you want to plug a website or something?
Busy day. Well, you know what? Right now, if you want to go check out coldarmy.com, that's the Cold website, and egyptcentral.com. Those are the guys right up on stage right now. So check it out. Great bands.
So I'm going to ask a couple of questions. Absolutely. Probably the stuff no one else asks.
Okay.
How does someone get to do your job?
How do they get to do my job? Well, I'm wondering how I
have,
got this job.
For the guitar, if you're not on stage, this is like the second greatest job you could have.
Absolutely.
Is you know, setting up the guitars right, you know, next to / on stage.
Absolutely. You know, I've been a guitar player myself since I was 12 years old. I'm 22 now. Drew Molleur is actually a personal friend and bandmate of mine. We've got a band on the side called Bad Axis, and you can check that out at badaxis.com.
Can you spell that?
Yeah, BADAXIS.com, Bad Axis, and we're actually going to be releasing our CD on May 15th as well, so you can pre-order that right now. But like I said, I'm in a band with Drew Molleur, the rhythm guitar player, and he gave me a call one day, said, hey, we're going out on the road. I know that you know how to work around guitars, so you know you want to come out for us. So definitely big thank you to Drew coming out with these guys, and that's how I got this gig.
Gotcha.
You know, just, but...
Now, where are you from?
I'm from Michigan initially, but I've been based in Nashville for the last 4 years. Gotcha. So I've been doing a lot of work, been around a lot of guitars and setups. And
so you are on the road?
Yes, sir.
Gotcha.
Yes, sir.
22 years old, man. You got your whole career and life ahead of you. This is a very exciting time for you.
Absolutely. I'm enjoying it every day.
Yeah. So tell us a little bit about the equipment that you have. Is this your rig?
No, this is actually the rig that Cold has on the road with them. We call this Guitar World. Basically, I've got a padded surface here that's not going to mar up the guitars at all. A little bit of a neck cradle so I can do some work on the tuning pegs in the neck. I've got my Korg rack tuner here so I can do my tuning. Like I said, I got my surface, I got my tuner, my cables, you know, my work light, everything like that, just to, you know, give me a comfortable place to work. And drawer wise I've got, you know, all the tools, cables I need to basically respond to any kind of situation I need to on stage. You know, if an amp goes out, a cable goes out, I've got everything I need in here, from cables, picks, to amplifier tubes and direct boxes and all that kind of stuff.
And how do you know if something is wrong on stage?
Well, first off, you'll see the band members. But no, you know, usually part of my job is once the show is rolling, I need to be right here on the side of the stage, and I need to have eye contact with everybody in the band, even the drummer, you know, making sure everything's cool, everything's running the way it is.
And so you are their EMT?
Absolutely am. I'm their first line of defense if they've got something that goes wrong.
First line of defense, right.
Yes, sir.
Triage.
Absolutely.
So what guitar do we have up here right now?
Right now, this is Jeff from Egypt Central. He's got a 20th anniversary PRS double cut. Just doing a restring, reset up on it, making sure that the action, the level of the strings above the fretboard, no buzz.
Sure.
Making sure everything's firing on all four cylinders. And as you can see, this thing's been on the road a little while, so we're not too worried about the cosmetics.
It's nice to see a guitar that's got personality.
Absolutely, and you know, I'm not one of those guys that likes to see a guitar that's bought to live on the wall. You know, I think that they were made to be played and they should be played.
Right.
I love seeing guitars like this.
Nice. So tell me about some of the guitars we have over here.
This here is Zach Gilbert's main axe. It's a ESP LTD 1000 Eclipse, Floyd Rose tremolo system, EMG 81 and 60. Active pickups, really hot output, great guitar. locking double trims so you can do your whammy bar stuff, you know, totally slack strings, go back perfectly in tune.
Nice. So I noticed the cover's not on the back of that either. Can we take a look at the back?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, so these are just the tension rods that you adjust to make sure that your action is offset with this whammy bar so that you can get it to float properly. With these, you can actually go down as well as up, get the Steve Vai effect, you know, really make it scream.
Nice.
And, next, this is Drew Molleur's main axe. Call this one Beauty. This is actually, if I remember the story correctly, this is actually the first guitar that was purchased for him, first electric anyhow.
Right.
And
that is a wild paint job.
Yeah, and
may I?
Absolutely.
Nice.
This guitar actually looks nothing like it used to.
Okay.
I didn't see it in its first incarnation, but
so
basically,
which kind of guitar is that?
This is actually kind of a Frankenstein.
Okay.
He got the guitar. He liked the body. The neck wasn't too good, so he bought a Warmoth replacement neck.
Nice.
Threw
Let's flip that over.
Yeah,
we
absolutely.
Have that nice and sanded off. Very, very sweet.
And automotive screws even holding on the hardware there.
Beautiful.
So this is definitely a one of a kind.
Got and, that little bit of Brian May thing. What does he have? The motorcycle, you know, parts for the trim.
Yeah. Right, and this is actually a paint job that he drew on and taped off himself.
You know, that's why I wanted to feel this, because it looks three-dimensional. I don't know if the camera could pick it up, but it's perfectly clear-coated and polished out.
Right.
Very
absolutely.
Cool paint job.
Absolutely. And, yeah, so he had a buddy of his do this paint job for him, and he's actually hoping one day to get a certain manufacturer to make this guitar for him as a signature series. So, you know, stay tuned for that.
Okay.
Then next, we got Sweet Brown Sugar. This is Sweet Brown Sugar here. It's a,
I like how they have their own names.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. This is a 67 Gibson SG.
Wow.
We need to do a little bit of work on it. As you see, we've got some electrical tape holding on the switch there, so we need to do some soldering. But, you know, this is just a rock and roll machine.
Sure.
Classic, vintage,
yep,
beautiful piece.
Beautiful.
Here we've got Zach Gilbert's number two guitar. This is a F-Series from ESP. It's kind of the same setup, except we've got two passive Duncans instead of the active EMGs. Floating trim, neck through body, five-piece neck.
I always like this guitar. I mean, it's very, very ornate.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of wood.
And
the five-piece necks, if we could flip that around, anytime you see the guitar that has a five-piece neck, very, very strong construction versus like a single piece or, you know, any sort of single piece of wood, it's actually, this is all sandwiched together, very strong neck. So definitely some quality and craftsmanship in this
absolutely.
One here.
Absolutely, and also just to add on to what you were saying about those neck throughs, these really let the strings reverberate with the body a lot better. You get a lot more sustain, a lot better tone as well.
Yep. Nice.
Then next up, we have the Jeremy Marshall Signature Series Bass, 5-string ESP, totally custom. It's all tricked out. He's got his signature cold spider inlays, these are passive EMG HZ pickups, active preamp controls.
That's also neck through on the back.
Yeah, absolutely. Neck through, great heel on it.
Yep.
Lots of low end coming from this bad boy. And then we just got another one of those as a backup for him, and we got another one in the case.
Nice. And I also like how we have the, let's bring that one back.
Absolutely.
The glow-in-the-dark
glow-in-the-dark tape.
Yep. That's one of the things, you know, I'm a guitar player also, one of the things I struggle with, sometimes you get something that doesn't have any fret markers or they're too little, and you just, the reality is, sometimes you lose place.
Absolutely.
So this is real, this is pretty smart, because they're large. And I noticed when you brought it over there, it glows in the dark. So
yeah, cold really enjoys to have a lower light setting as well. And so a lot of times we'll do a complete blackout in between the songs. So that'll just give them a good starting point.
There's a tip for you.
Absolutely. Sweet. Yeah, we're running a Hughes & Kettner Triamp as well as a Mesa Dual Rectifier. And then Zach is using a Splawn Quick Rod and a Mesa Stiletto for his tones.
Okay.
Jeremy's been using a Mesa 400 Plus for his bass tones. And right now we're actually running an Ampeg SVT3 Pro as well.
Beautiful.
So,
any pedals?
Yeah, we've got lots of pedals for Zach. We're, you know, he usually runs straight through. He's got a DL4 delay unit from Line 6 he uses a lot. Big muff for some fuzz tones.
Seen a lot of that Line 6 delay pedal. It's like go-to
absolutely.
Pedal.
Absolutely. And in fact, Drew, his entire rig is set up with a Line 6 M13 modeler unit.
Ah,
so
okay.
You've got, you know, 48 scenes where you can make every tone that you want to. You can just, you know, step on one control, get to his next song. So really a lot of control at your feet.
Yep, awesome. Well, listen, thank you very much. It was
Absolutely, a pleasure talking
with you and giving us the tour, and appreciate it very much.
Absolutely.
Let's leave everyone over with a little rock and roll, and later on.